Hi everyone, welcome back to RSB One Stop. Microsoft has released its July monthly non-security preview update KB5028254, with build number 22621.2070 for Windows 11, version 22H2. This update was installed silently in the background while I was working on other content, as I had turned on the toggle to receive updates as soon as they were made available. If you're as eager as me to receiving updates as soon as they're released, then be sure to turn on the toggle immediately. Now, coming to the update. This is a minor update with not many visual changes. This update may also carry some preliminary features of 23H2, with it that will be enabled once the 23H2 update is released. The latest preview update addresses a number of issues, including brightness settings, display and audio devices, widgets, VPNs, Windows Defender Application Control, WDAC, and the FastFAT file system driver. Brightness settings are now more accurate. This means that your screen will be brighter or dimmer depending on your needs, and you won't have to adjust the settings as often. Certain display and audio devices will no longer be missing after your system resumes from sleep. This is a major improvement for users who have experienced this issue in the past. Widgets will no longer unpin from the taskbar unexpectedly. This is a welcome change for users who rely on widgets for quick access to information. VPNs will no longer have excessive ARP requests to the network gateway. This will improve network performance for users who use VPNs. The Windows Push Notification Services, WNS, have been improved to be more reliable. This means that you will be less likely to experience problems with notifications. The Windows Kernel Vulnerable Driver Blocklist, driversipolicy.p7b, has been updated to add drivers that are at risk for Bring Your Own Vulnerable Driver, BIOVD, attacks. This will improve security. The reporting of L2 cache on certain CPUs has been improved. This will provide more accurate information about your system's performance. Apart from the highlighted changes, there are a few other improvements made in this update. I will leave the link in description for the official change log. That's all for this update, thanks for watching. Please do like and subscribe to the channel for more updates like this.